Chicago Bears, first round selection.
One of the greatest running back of all time, one of the greatest football players of all time, Walter Payton. Coming from Jackson State University, from my hometown.
Walter Payton, running back, Jackson State.
I'd gotten a call, and it was Jim Finks. He asked me, how would I like to play for the Bears? I said, it doesn't matter who I play for. I'm going to play as hard as I can.
The scouts knew about Walter, but the public didn't know about it. You know, everyone said, who's Walter Payton? Well, he wanted to show people who Walter Payton was.
Payton left the college ranks as the leading scorer in NCAA history, a gifted runner whose competitive nature is never damped. And as a rookie for Chicago in 1975, showed he was eager to take on the record books of the NFL. Payton led his team in rushing and scoring in 75, and showed his great running ability on kickoff returns when he captured the NFL return crown. Now you've seen the type of men chosen to be Bears to build on.
If you couldn't make it with the team that you were drafted with, then and you had to go somewhere else, that was, to me, was a sign of failure.
He may get the corner turned, and he's in for the touchdown.
Once you put wisdom with will on top of talent, you get what you call sweetness.
Wear those shoulders, and boom!
You people in Chicago are spoiled. This guy you have down there is a phenomenon.
Haven't found anything he can't do.
He knew he was going to make that one play, that one big, gigantic leap. He just waited for it.
Peyton ricochets off Ronnie Lott.
No one performed with more class. He became the model.
Walter Payton shows why he should be the most expensive back in all of professional football. Phenomenal.
We were looking at this young man. His name is Payton. You cannot arm tackle him. I don't think he's quite 5'11". I think he's about 5'10". He bench presses 390. He is strong, fast, and you've got to use the shoulder and a lot of them.
They won't have a hard time selling tickets here with this young man. As long as he wears the Bear colors, this guy is something else.
Payton's running ability cannot be taught. Developed as a child in a simple game called tag.
I was always the last one to get caught. And if you got caught, you was it. And you had to catch everybody else. And I knew how hard it was, so I'd never want to get caught. So I would just be running and fading and sliding under and jumping over and just trying to get away.
Everyone was talking about this hot, new, sensational running back that they had, and sure enough, he was really special.
Perry in motion to the right side, toss Payton, sweeping away, turns to the outside, makes the cut to the end zone for the touchdown!
One time I pulled around the corner and Walter was behind me, and he said, don't hit the first guy, hit the second guy. I hit the second guy and sprung him for a long run. So back in the film session, we got a chance to take a look at it. The line coach said, how come you didn't hit the first guy? Walter whispered to me, don't hit him, I got him.
Everybody looks at this physical quality or that physical quality and forget about the heart.
He decides to keep it back against the grave.
And the heart's what makes the great ones. Walter Payton, he's too short my butt. I mean, he got the heart.
They were dogging me out. Everybody would say, oh, he's going to be a bust. He can't even do this. He can't do that. It's devastating. Don't be holding your head down. We're not just going to knock on the door. We're going to kick the damn door down.
Because he's going to produce.
Second down, 7, a delay to Payton. 30, 35, look out. He may go to the 40, to the 30. Walter Payton down to the 20. Walt Williams is trying to get him, and he's just inside the 5-yard line.
Payton was relentless, and he ran with a fury. It was like he was mad all the time, and he wanted to punish people, and he wanted to just get at them and attack them.
Payton again, and Walter Payton is in for the touchdown.
Now the big rush comes, and Avellini throws and gets a man. It's Walter Payton. And Payton is inside the 10. It's going to be touchdown, Chicago.
35-10, New Orleans. Pitch back goes to Walter Payton. Look at that run. Payton's going to take it in for a touchdown. Pitch back to Payton. And Walter Payton, look at this kid play football. Isn't he something? He's going to go the distance possibly.
First time I saw him on television, and I didn't know who he was. And I said, oh my goodness, what kind of animal is this? What kind of guy is this? All those moves and the strength and the tenacity. That was it. I didn't have to see any more. I knew this was a great run.
Second down, 5, Payton, and Payton's got the first down. Look at him run across the 40 to the 35, and Payton's all the way inside the 30-yard line.
I'm telling you, people just didn't want to tackle him. He punished him.
He wouldn't take a way out by running through the sidelines. He'd come, if it were you and him, he would come straight at you.
From the 36, a gain of a half yard. Up the middle, here comes Payton. To the 45, he may go. He's to the 35, the 30. Walter Payton is cut off.
just outside the 5-yard line.
As first and goal.
Avellini, here comes Peyton. And Peyton is in for the touchdown.
Unbelievable. It was simply extra effort by Walter Peyton. That's why he's the best in the NFL there is.
Avellini to Walter Peyton. Look at Peyton inside the 5. He's going to fight his way down close to that goal line.
I fell in love with one clip. It was a run that he had against the Kansas City Chiefs.
Peyton. Oh, he's still on his feet. It's Walter Peyton.
Another piece of art.
And ever since then, that's my guy.
Yeah, I kind of liken him to James Brown, the hardest working man in showbiz. Boy, Walter Peyton was one of the hardest working football players to play out there.
I do think he's the most complete back that I've ever seen. Taught himself how to be a really good receiver. He wasn't when he came into the league, but he got better at it.
By playing here, I developed all my skills.
Peyton open, and Peyton's got it.
Whereas if I went to Pittsburgh because they had Stallworth and these other guys, Lane Swan, they wouldn't need me to catch passes.
Here's Walter Peyton. Peyton on his feet. Peyton stiff arms and Peyton for the 7th.